Hi, Lillian. I'm Audrey.
Hi, how are
you? Welcome to Kleinfeld, sweetheart.
Thank you. My name is Lillian Harden. I have brought with me my mother, Peggy, and Carla, and my husband, Kevin. My husband and I are already married. We just did a civil wedding, so now we're going to have a ceremony for family and friends.
How did the two of you meet?
We met at Walter Reed Army Medical Center when I was his non-medical attendant.
I was deployed in Samarra, Iraq, and I was a medic, and I was there for 13 months.
He was there getting ready to actually go home.
We were on one of our last major missions. We got ambushed. Anti-tank missile came through the Humvee, went through me. Got three pieces of shrapnel in my brain, almost took off my whole left hand and right hand.
He had altogether 34 surgeries.
Even to this day, I'm still going through rehab. I wouldn't be able to do any of that without Lillian, you know, and I love her.
They have gone through a lot, and they have stood by each other. They have held each other up.
I think him and Lillian find strength in one another. And I think they're there to support each other. And that makes this appointment even that more special.
As far as price point, where do you think you'll be most comfortable?
We have a budget of $2,000. My name is Carla Marrero, and I help an organization called Christmas Can Cure. It's an avenue to be able to give something back to our veterans.
The gown might be about $2,000, but I guarantee you will look like $1 million.
Thank you.
Kevin's mom had written us a letter and told us they really wanted to have their special wedding and weren't able to because of finances. So we're going to pay for Lillian's wedding dress, and we're going to actually put on their perfect wedding.
Now they're going to get their full-blown traditional wedding that they really deserve.
What do you see Lillian wearing?
She's always been my little princess.
You'd like to see her in something princessy?
Yes, I would.
Generally, a princess ball gown can be much more expensive than your regular gown because there's a lot more embellishment and a lot more fabric.
His recovery is coming along.
Yes. His spirit never breaks down. He's very strong.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Good luck to you, sweetie.
Thank you.
People have asked me before if I regret anything that's happened to me, like my injuries or whatnot. And things have a weird way of working out. Go to Walter Reed, meet the woman of my dreams. I don't know what I'd do if I never met her.
I'm gonna cry because this poor boy was very badly hurt, and he is not the least bit angry. And to me, that's what makes you very, very special.
I just wanna make sure I can get them whatever they want. And if the dress is more than $2,000, if I have to put it in, I will.
Come on up.
What do you guys think?
I think it's perfect.
It is. It's beautiful.
She looked unbelievable. When she walked out, I would love to have that feeling like at the wedding.
Yeah.
She definitely needs more sparkle. That's a little more sparkle.
I am a very glittery.
She's very, very, didn't give the wow factor. It's not my daughter.
So Lillian goes back to find a dress that will make mom happy. As she steps into the next gown, Kevin suddenly has a change of heart and heads to the back.
Now that we're having a huge ceremony, I actually want to be surprised when the actual ceremony happens.
He realized that this was something more special than he actually thought it would be.
Come on in.
I don't want to look. Because after seeing how you looked in the first dress, as beautiful as you were, I really want to be surprised for that day. I think I should go out there and wait outside.
Okay.
You okay?
Yeah.
Babe. Hey.
Don't follow me.
Give me a kiss. I love you.
I love you too.
He had the sensitivity to realize he wanted to be surprised on the day of their wedding.
Lillian gets into a dress that has everything she's looking for, but it's $900 over her budget.
I really like this dress.
Wow. Ladies,
I absolutely love it. That's the one.
Yep. Lillian found the perfect dress. The emotion that I saw is pretty amazing. It is beautiful.
So is this your dress?
I think so.
Lillian loves the dress, but it's way over her price point.
If I have to beg, borrow, or steal, I would have made it my business that she had it.
$2,000 is the budget.
Okay.
How low can you go?
$1,599? Okay.
She brings the dress from $2,900 down to $1,599. Miracles do happen. $1,599.
Oh.
Did it work out really well?
Yeah. Really well. We got it done.
Fantastic.
Wow.
So is this your dress?
Yes.
Yes? Okay.
She looks breathtaking.
To think when he sees you for the first time in this.
I think he's gonna be stunned. He's gonna be shocked.
Do you like the headpiece and veil?
We got the price down. But when we came to the veil and the headpiece, we were still a little over budget. Randy and I just looked, and it's only a few hundred dollars. So we decided that we would split the difference.
This is our very minor way of showing our gratitude towards them and for what they've done.
The dress makes me feel incredible. She's gorgeous. She's a princess in it.
Debbie, welcome
to Klein Fells. Nice to meet you. Thank you. My name is Michelle, and I'm here from Toronto. I had to come to Klein Fells to try on the paninas.
When a bride comes in and says, I want a Panina Tournée gown, she has some kind of concept of what something like that is going to cost her. Panina Tournée dresses do not come cheap. Trust me.
I brought my mom, Anna, my sister, maid of honor, Susan, and my eldest niece, Shayna.
Debbie takes the group back to find out more about Michelle's top paninas.
So I love that.
You're probably looking at about a $20,000 dress.
That's... I have very expensive taste.
I know paninas are a little more expensive, so I don't really want to give a budget because if I love it, I love it.
I am the one who is going to pay, but we didn't put a budget for it.
My mother will do whatever Michelle wants because she wants to make Michelle happy.
We don't really have a budget.
Everyone has some number in mind. There has to be some magic cutoff point.
This one's really nice, too. How much is this one?
I want to say it's
$14,000. $14,000 on a wedding dress. It's a lot of money, so I don't know.
You okay?
You like this one?
So nice.
I love it. I love this dress. Mom, what do you think?
I love it.
It's so expensive that I was hoping I wouldn't like it.
It's the perfect dress. But Michelle is starting to waver.
I have to, it's a lot, you know?
She looks in the mirror, and all of a sudden, it was just like it was a surprise to her how much this dress actually cost.
But it's expensive. It's inexpensive. It's really expensive.
It's kind of becoming a little bit of a reality that this is a $14,000 dress.
It's hard when my parents gave her free rein to get what she wants, and then she has to start debating whether it's worth it.
I would not want to be in Michelle's shoes right now.
It's a lot. I did not realize how it would feel to spend $14,000 on a wedding dress. I don't know. Should I try on that dress that I tried on? I don't know if you have it, the Maggie one. I've tried on the Maggie dress before in Toronto, and I loved it then.
I'll do a little bit of research. Let's see if we have the dress.
Okay.
Let's see.
If Michelle had told me in the beginning of this appointment that she was in love with a $1,500 dress, it would have been a completely different appointment.
Turn that thing off for a minute so I could scream.
She's really frustrated at this point, and, you know, understandably so.
Go right ahead.
Maggie Sotero dress.
I love it.
I love them both. I don't know which one to choose.
I think Michelle, she's a very practical person.
This is so difficult.
It's gonna be hard for her to justify in her mind $1,500 versus $14,000.
I know the value of a dollar. My parents came from Russia and they worked so hard for their money. As much as they can spend that money on me now, I don't think I can do it. To tell you the truth, I'm looking at this dress, and I'm really loving it. I think I have to let it sink in.
Okay.
I think I need to think about it.
Okay.
I'm leaving today without a dress. I think I need to sleep on it.
Michelle did see the dress in Ontario, and it doesn't make any sense for her to purchase that dress at Kleinfeld. I don't think I'll ever see Michelle again.
Michelle leaves the store empty-handed. She never returns.